美国跟英国的情报机构都认定中国是全世界最大的有规模、有计划、由国家所形成的骇客组织。过去大家认为是俄罗斯，他们现在指控的主要是中国，而中国很可能会攻击的是美国的基础建设，包括北欧还有好几个国家跟竞选有关的资料，针对的是政治人物。他们最担心的是台海一旦发生任何危机的时刻，这些骇客组织可能会造成什么样的破坏行为。
Every day, a force from the Far East has a singular mission: to steal the secrets of American business. Intellectual property, blueprints for existing and emerging technologies, research and development advances, and merger and acquisition opportunities.
Stark and stunning warnings, the United States vulnerable and at risk.
Preparation to wreak havoc and cause real-world harm to American citizens and communities.
Chinese hackers targeting America, but why? And how can they be stopped?
There's no reason for them to be in our water. There's no reason for them to be in our power.
纽约时报十年前就指出，美中两国正在网络空间进行一场新冷战。随着两大强权对抗逐年升高，这场没有烟消味的战争战况仍炽。
Using an alphabet of state-linked hacking groups, Beijing is accused of infiltrating government institutions and companies around the world. Much of their interest is economic advantage, but also a desire to snoop on those perceived as dissidents or critics of China.
3月25日，美国司法部、英国外交部和纽西兰反间谍机构同时指控有国家支持的中国骇客对该国发动恶意网络攻击。
When it was revealed the Electoral Commission had been hacked, some pointed the finger at Russia. But the government has revealed those after the personal details of 40 million people were Chinese.
The Deputy Prime Minister,
Oliver Dowden, told the Commons hackers known as APT31, or Judgment Panda, attempted to spy on parliamentarians. They didn't succeed, but the threat was real and serious.
That is why the United Kingdom has today sanctioned two individuals and one entity associated with the Chinese state-affiliated APT31 group.
遭制裁的实体是湖北省武汉小睿智科技有限责任公司，以及隶属于该公司的两名中国公民倪高斌及赵光宗。
At the same time, the U.S. announced sanctions and charges against the same hacking group.
Targets include White House staff, U.S. senators, British MPs, and officials around the world who are critical of China. And in an indictment that was unsealed on Monday against seven of the alleged Chinese hackers, U.S. prosecutors said that they targeted emails, they targeted online storage, and the phone call records of millions of Americans.
美国司法部和联邦调查局也指控了包括被英国制裁的倪赵二人与另外五名中国公民，对美国实施了长达14年广泛的网络攻击活动。
APT31, alias Judgment Panda, is a Chinese hacking group almost certainly responsible for hacking the email accounts of UK MPs linked to criticism of China, says the UK National Cybersecurity Centre. APT31 used a technique called spear phishing, the same as phishing in which a user is tricked into downloading malware by clicking on an innocent-looking link, except spear phishing is targeted at a specific individual or group, usually via their email addresses.
美国国务院表示，缩写为 APT31 的高级长期威胁31是一群由中国支持的情报人员与合约骇客组成的团体。他们为中国国家安全部的垂直管理机构湖北省国家安全厅进行恶意网络侵入行动。
Officials warn China is looking to target critical infrastructure across the country.
Now imagine that on a massive scale. Imagine not one pipeline, but many pipelines disrupted. Telecommunications going down so people can't use their cell phone. People start getting sick from polluted water.Trains get derailed, air traffic control system, port control systems are malfunctioning. This is truly an everything, everywhere, all at once scenario.
网络时代，各种重要资讯传递都在弹指之间。美中两国在国家安全战略架构中，早就已经将网络空间视为新战场。美国国防部2011年7月中旬发布了网络作战战略，明确要求五角大厦将网络视同作战领域。 至于中国国防部也在2011年5月为应对网络威胁成立了网络蓝军，以提升军队的网络安全防护能力。
The United States is now the most targeted country in the world for cyber attacks.
中国政府部门几乎每天都在遭受海量的网络攻击，其中大多数源头都来自美国。中国才是网络攻击的最大受害者。美国不要给中国乱扣帽子。
面对美国与盟友的指控，中国也自称是网暴的受害者。2023年5月，中国国家电脑病毒紧急处理中心和360公司就公布了一份骇客帝国调查报告，揭秘美国中情局如何利用网络攻击他国进行间谍窃密活动。报告指，透过实证分析发现，美国中情局网络武器使用了极为严格的间谍技术规范，现在已经覆盖全球几乎所有互联网和物联网资产，可以随时随地控制别国网络，盗取别国重要的敏感数据。中国官媒批评美国式的网络霸权可见一斑，骇客任务实至名归。
大肆的炒作所谓的中国网络攻击，甚至发起对华的无理单边制裁，中方对此坚决反对。
美中两国在网络空间的这场看不见的战役越演越烈，也验证了近期的战场不在沙场，而是在云端，在所谓的认知作战。